My name is RJ Disha Oberoi, and today is the 88th Indian Air Force Day. We here at Rare FM will be taking you through some amazing stories from our forces. Gear up! The Indian Air Force played a significant role in the 1960 Congo crisis and in the annexation of Goa. The Indian Air Force supported the United Nations operation in Congo to fight the 75-year rule of Belgium over Congo. The Indian Air Force worked in sync with the United Nations to destroy the rebel Air Force in Congo. The Indian Air Force went on to stay there for 6 years till 1966, till the United Nations mission wasn't over. In 1961, the Indian government decided to attack the Portuguese colony in Goa. This is after years of disagreement between Delhi and Lisbon. The Indian Air Force worked in conjunction with the ground forces, and they destroyed the wireless station in the enemy territory, making them lose all connectivity. Oregon's, called the Tufanis in the Indian Air Force, eventually destroyed the runway at Diu. They destroyed the control towers, the wireless station, and the Met station. Once the Portuguese surrendered, the former colony was integrated into India. This was the first very successful mission by the Indian Air Force post-independence. Jai Hind.
Hi, main hoon Rubina, aur aaj hai Indian Air Force Day. Let's talk about the Indo-Pak War, which was one of the biggest aerial combat which took place in September 1965 after the conflict began following Operation Gilbalter. India and Pakistan Air Forces engaged in large-scale aerial combat against each other from the time of partition. The aerial war saw both sides conducting thousands of stories in single month. Even though Pakistan had technological superiority, Indian Air Force was able to prevent Pakistan from gaining air superiority in conflict due to one strategy. Even though Pakistan had technological superiority, Indian Air Force was able to prevent Pakistan from gaining air superiority in conflict due to their strategies. By the end of the conflict, Indian Air Force lost 60 to 70 aircraft and Pakistan lost 43 aircraft. This war was the biggest learning for Indian Air Force. After the war, the Indian Air Force underwent a series of changes to improve its capabilities, due to which today, India stands fourth place among the strongest Air Force list.
Perhaps one of the biggest victories for the Indian Air Force in wars against Pakistan was the 1971 Indo-Pak War. Full 10 days before the war for liberation of Bangladesh started, Pakistan Air Force also launched preemptive strikes against Indian Air Force at bases in Ambala, in Srinagar, in Jodhpur and other areas. The Indian Air Force did not suffer any significant damages in these preemptive strikes by Pakistan because they had anticipated such movements. When Indian Air Force launched their attack on the Pakistan Air Force, the effect on the PAF was devastating. By the end of the war, by Indian estimates, while India had lost only 45 aeroplanes, Pakistan had lost 94 of its airplanes. Pakistan lost half its country, its forces in the east, and had to publicly surrender to India. It was the largest military surrender by any country after World War II. The Indian Air Force played a significant role in the victory over Pakistan in the battle for Bangladesh back in 1971. This was just another chapter in the glorious history of the Indian Air Force. Jai Hind.
I'm RJ Angira and I host the afternoon show. Well, I'm going to go to my favorite part. Did you know? Did you know that the Siachen Glacier is at a height of 24,000 feet in the eastern range of Ladakh in the Himalayas, of course? But here's the thing. Do you remember the time when this top was captured by enemy troops? Well, let's rewind to 36 years back. 13th April 1984, the Indian troops snatched the control of the Siachen Glacier in northern Kashmir, narrowly beating Pakistan. Well, today, 36 years later, like I said, the two sides remain locked in a standoff. But the Indian Army mountaineer who inspired the operation, well, he has to say that no matter what happens, we got to make sure that this place remains ours. It was also called Operation Meghdoot. You know where this came from? It was derived from the Sanskrit poem by Kalidasa. It's called the Operation Cloud Messenger, a code name for the Indian Armed Forces to seize control of this part of course, the Himalayan range. Now, why am I telling you this? I'm telling you this because today is Indian Air Force Day, where without these brave officers, without all the sacrifices that they have made for us, we wouldn't stand a chance. We wouldn't be here. So I think it's time that we pay our due. Well, let's salute and give a big shout out on Indian Air Force Day to all those brave officers, all those people who stand their guard just to make sure we are safe. Jai Hind.
Hi guys, my name is Tuhin. I host the evening show on Super Hits 93.5 Red FM called KA935. Well, today we are talking about Kargil War. Yes, 20 years ago, along with Army, Air Force launched an operation called Operation Safed Sagar to neutralize all the enemies, and which was bang on. All the aircrafts at that time, MiG-21, 27, 29, Mi-17 attack helicopters, Jaguar, and the hero of the war, Mirage 2000 was used. Mirage 2000 came in the end when MiG-21 and 27 were shot down by Pakistan. But then Mirage 2000 neutralized everyone because of its high altitude capability and the attack and reconnaissance capabilities. So total 578 airstrikes, 462 captures and escorts, and reconnaissance 159. So in all, 1,199 operations were carried out by the Indian Air Force. We salute our Indian Air Force, and we cannot forget the sacrifice of our armed forces. We bombarded all the camps and posts captured by Pakistan, and on 26th of July, we sent them back to their country. We reclaimed Tiger Hill and our Tiranga was hoisted there. Wish you a very happy Indian Air Force Day. Jai Hind.